Okay, folks, so I'm going to do a demonstration here on this tool that is one tool. There are other tools for building what most websites have nowadays into them is this nav bar on mobile. That's kind of the three lines that you'll hear me refer to as the cheeseburger menu, right? Kind of looks like a McDouble, there you go. And so the tool is called SlickNav, and again, there are other tools, but I'm just gonna kind of walk through a quick demonstration of how you would get up and running using SlickNav. So I'm just gonna, you know, for the sake of this one, open up Visual Studio Code, and you know, I've already got a folder open. I'll make a subfolder here just called SlickNav, just so this is the folder that I'm putting everything in. Obviously, this is not the root. Actually, let me open up SlickNav folder. For whatever reason, this is in my chapter 9 homework. Okay, now my SlickNav folder is the root. Okay, now the website, if you just Google search SlickNav, we kind of come up with this top link for the website, and this is a github.io. Get started with mobile awesomeness, download now. Okay, let's click on download now. This is going to take you to a GitHub where you can download a zip file. Now I'll keep this zip file in my downloads, but you're going to want to extract this zip folder into the directory that you're working in. So I'm going to click on extract. Now I have to navigate to my folder with my SlickNav directory, right? Into my SlickNav folder. So here we go. Here we go. I think I said homework, chapter 9. There's SlickNav. I'm just going to click select folder. And I'm going to click extract. Now there's a lot of stuff going on inside this folder. If I kind of dive down into this, here's this jQuery slicknav.js. If I go into dist, these are basically the same thing. Here's my JavaScript, here's some CSS. So there's two files that are really important here, the CSS and the JavaScript. Turns out that these two JavaScript files are the exact same files. One is just minimized and the other is not. So if I actually look at this in like Notepad++, this one you can kind of see is for developer's eyes. It's kind of readable with a bunch of comments and white space. And if you really want to go in behind the scenes, you can start to tell what's going on with the code that's written in here. But if I look at the minimized version, this is not really readable. It's actually just one giant line of code. All the white space is removed. But the minimized files are what you typically use for deployment and like development environments, live environments, whereas the non-minimized is more for reading the docs. Okay, so really two files that matter are the minimized CSS and the minimized JavaScript. I'll go ahead and copy these. I'll go back up to root now. And I'll just go ahead and make a new folder for my CSS, and I'll paste this in here, and then I'll cut the rest out because I don't really care about the rest. And then I'll come in here and I'll make a new folder for my JavaScript, and I'll paste the important JavaScript in here that I need, and I'll just delete the rest. Okay, so I've got my JavaScript file, I've got my CSS file. At this point, I don't really need this SlickNav folder anymore, this subfolder, but I'll keep it there because it's not hurting anything. Back into code. Let's make my index page. And let's go ahead and link up to these files, SlickNav demo. Of course, to link to CSS, we're going to go into our CSS folder, and there's our minimize CSS. And to link to a JavaScript file is with the script tag. Right, so we haven't had to do this before. This is new for my class, but very much like you link to an external CSS file with the link tag, to link to a JavaScript is just with the script tag. Of course, this is in the JS folder, and there's our minimized JavaScript. Now, SlickNav, if you kind of look back at the docs, SlickNav has a dependency, which is jQuery 1.7+. So if you kind of go down to the requirements, it says it requires jQuery 1.7. And by the way, here's kind of a SlickNav with some bouncing action going on, right? So this is kind of where we're going here. Here's a basic demo. This is where we're kind of going to get today. But you can kind of see the markup in the JavaScript for this advanced. Anyways, point is, it requires jQuery. What is jQuery? Well, jQuery is a library built on top of JavaScript that was really popular and still is used in a lot of websites. That kind of gives us some animation type effects, like what you're seeing here with the scrolling effect and the bouncing effect. jQuery makes it pretty easy to do this. So we also need to wrap in jQuery. It turns out that's pretty easy. Let's go to jQuery.com. And actually, if you just kind of Google it, you can see the CDN, which is a content delivery network. And I'm just going to go to we need 1.7, but here's 3, which should be compatible. And here is a script tag to kind of link in this library called jQuery. So I'm just going to copy this, the latest jQuery CDN, and you have to link to this above SlickNav, right? So once we link to the SlickNav CSS, and we link to the SlickNav JavaScript, before that, I'm going to link to jQuery because this JavaScript file needs this to be loaded in. So the order actually matters. Okay, the next step is I'm going to go ahead and write a custom CSS called styles. And if I kind of organize this a little better, the order does matter, but let's just do SlickNav CSS, and then I'll do my custom CSS. Then I'll kind of wrap in jQuery, and then I'll wrap in SlickNav. And now I've got my styles.css, and if I just do something like background body selector, background pink, just wrap this in and make sure that our CSS is good to go. Okay, we got a pink background. And we're up and running. Now, that's all that's required to get out of the gates with SlickNav. A pretty typical menu for HTML is going to be inside of a nav tag, and then you very commonly see an unordered list with LIs and then A's. And so this structure here, let me format it up. Notice it has some extra classes going on here, and some identifiers to kind of scroll to the different places on the page, but let's just glance at this now. Real standard. we haven't styled our navbar yet, and we can kind of go in here and begin applying our own custom styles. Like we might, in this case, our menu, we might want our menu to display flex and list style type of none. Right? We could take our CSS here and justify content space evenly, right? So we just get a real standard nav bar. We might take our links and continue to style those out. Color, text decoration, none. Color. I am recording this, yep. I'm gonna tell our links to display. Don't forget your semicolons, display block. And I'm gonna put a quick border on these. Just kind of make them look like buttons. And so we just add some padding. Right, and whatever you wanna do for your styling on these things, it doesn't make a whole ton of difference. Background color, you know, whatever you wanna do for your links to get them styled in a nav bar. This is really quite an ugly nav bar, but point is you can start styling it with your custom CSS here. Now back to the docs. The next thing to do is initialize your SlickNav. And this basically is the run button, right? By looping in this script, this is gonna call a function called SlickNav, which is basically gonna get this thing up and running. So I'm gonna copy in this script underneath right here, do a little styling. And by default, you get this going on. Of course, you don't want this menu being displayed all the time, so we need to hide the menu. That's kind of what we're gonna do next. And then display the menu when we use a media query, right? So using some media queries, we're going to hide and show things appropriately. Back at the docs, you could see here in our CSS, we're gonna hide the SlickNav menu. So here, this SlickNav menu, this is a class of SlickNav menu. Now this is kind of what the JavaScript is doing. The JavaScript is building this SlickNav menu for us. So this class of SlickNav menu. Notice that goes away. And now we can write a media query. At media, and I'll say at media only screen and minimum width. Max width, no, min width, 600 pixels. Okay. At media only screen and min width, 600 pixels.
Actually, do you want it min width? Because that's 600 pixels or not.
Yeah, we want to do the other way. So this is desktop first, so we need to go down. So that is correct. Since we styled our CSS here for the desktop, it's desktop down, so we want to do a max width and maybe make this visible underneath 600 pixels. And so you can kind of see here to hide the original menu, we're gonna do display none. Now, I'm gonna point this out. If I just copy this right from the docs in right here, this turns out, okay, let's bring that. Yeah, that didn't work. And so that's what I noticed when I just did this prior. I actually need to change my selector to get rid of the, remember this is a child selector when you have a space. So this says the class of JavaScript. I'm just gonna get rid of that and get rid of that. So now you kind of see, and this is what we're looking for, right? When you get below that 600 pixels, and you can determine your width, when you get below the 600 pixels, bam, we got the cheeseburger menu, right? And this is to just get it up and running. That's now working, and that's great. You can build this out if you read the documentation and look at all these different options to you, and these different ways to modify using some jQuery. Again, you can get this a little bit more, I don't know, animated, if you will. But that's the quick how to get up and running quickly with some SlickNavs.